Hi, and welcome to another episode of Mr. Puzzle. Today, we will have a look at this puzzle here, which is called the aerodynamics puzzle. And it is, as you can see, it is a wire puzzle. And the target of this puzzle is to remove this arrow from the rest of the parts. The puzzle is coming in this box here. And it is sold by Puzzle Master, which is a company located in Canada, and they have a great website. Actually, my favorite website for puzzles, since they have thousands of puzzles in their portfolio, and anything you can imagine. And I really like to go through their shop and check out what is available there. So check it out. I will put you also the link for this puzzle in the description that you can have a look and buy it if you would like to. So the puzzle itself is also sold under the brand Puzzle Master, and it has a difficulty of the hardest difficulty available at puzzlemaster.canada of 10 out of 10. They start from 5 to 10, not as we do here on this channel from 1 to 5. But this one has the highest difficulty, so it should be very challenging. And again, as I already said, you need to remove the arrow from the rest of the parts. So the quality is very well for a wire puzzle. It's pretty heavy, it's solid wire, and it's nickel plated, I think, and also it's pretty stiff, so you cannot bend very much. And also, it's, if you see, it's pretty big, so it's very good to handle. And also, it's very tricky, I can say you already. How to solve it and how to remove the arrow from the rest of the parts, I will show you after the spoiler break. Okay, here we go. So, how to get the arrow out of this wire puzzle? Well, in the beginning I tried a lot of just playing around with this puzzle, somehow move it over here, move it through here, and so on. But it was not really progress. It seems not to be possible in the beginning. But when you start thinking about how to handle this puzzle, you get a better understanding how to do it. And this is what I did then. And with that, I was able to solve it. So I will just show you step by step now how to do it and explain each step why we go where. So in the beginning, I usually take this arrow here and move it, turn it around by 180 degrees. And the first thing I do is I attach it here to this upper part like this. So now it looks very confusing, but this will change when I move the arrow, the tip here of this arrow, the rear end, through here, over this part, and pull it out, because now it's free again. But something has changed compared to before. The arrow is now connected not only to this part, but also to this part. And now I will turn the arrow here, over here, and move it in the middle position of the upper part, like this. And also, at the same time, I will move it in the position of the middle part. So, and what happened now is, now the arrow is connected to this part, it's connected to this part, but not connected anymore to this part. As a next step, we now want to move it from here, or want to disconnect this part, that the arrow is only connected to this part. And this is how we do it. We go through this loop over here, through the other loop over here, connect here, connect, go through here, and connect it here through the again through this bar. And now we disconnect it again from this part by taking it and moving it over here and over here. And now I can pull it out here, so back through the loop again. And as I said before, now we are connected only to this part here. So what happened with all these moves? Well, with all these moves, we were able to move the arrow from the position in the beginning, which was down here, one step up to this one. And now we continue moving it another step up there. So, and this is one of my, what we do now is one of my favorite moves. We go through here, through this loop. We go through this loop. And then we connect it up here to the upper part again. Now we have a complete mess here. But now we disconnect it again from this part over here. Now I pull it out all the way and we end up in this condition. Still very confusing, so, but now what happened now is, if you look, we are only connected to this part, because when we turn it around and I make the wire go over here, we can see it is only connected to this part. It is not connected to this one anymore, and not connected to this one anymore. So we went again one level up. We went from here to here to here. And if you look in detail, you can already see when I'm now able to remove it from here, it's already done, because I can pull out the arrow through this loop here and it's free. So, and this is what we do now. We go through this hole, through this loop. We move it around here, we get it over here, and now the arrow is free. I know it's quite complicated and confusing. I also did it, believe me, I also did it several times to be able to do it here on camera. But in the end, we need to understand, we need to go from here to here to here, and then we can get it out. And that's the trick. And there are several moves necessary, but believe me, when you handle this for some time, you will be able to solve it by yourself, because you will understand what moves you need to do to get one step up, one step up, one step up and outside. Okay, so this was how to disassemble the puzzle, and now I'm gonna show you how to reassemble it. The reassembly I will do a little bit faster than the disassembly, because otherwise it will cost too much time. In the end, it's exactly the same order of sequence of steps, but other way around. So we will start over here through this loop, connect it up here again to the upper part, and then get off this one by going through here. And we are in this condition again. We move in the middle again by going over here. Now we do this move with the two loops again, going through here, over here, inside, out again, and we already one level down. Now we go through here, inside again. So the procedure is most of the times the same. Over here, around this part, back again. So now we are in this condition. move again over this loop here, so not through it but over it or around it, let's say, and also same on the lower one. So we go here and here at the same time behind this condition, and now you can see we are nearly done or back in the initial condition. Now I need to only remove it here again from this one, so I go over here, remove it from this side, from the ring, and we are back in the initial condition. Again, I know it's very confusing, but there is a logic procedure behind it. I really like this one. It gave me a good challenge. It took me about maybe 1 hour to solve it, or to be able to disassemble it for the reassembly. Then, since I knew how I did it, I was able to do it much faster, maybe in 15 minutes. But I really, really like this one. It's a very nice wire puzzle. It's very good to handle because it's not that small as most of the wire puzzle. Regarding the difficulty, maybe it will not get my highest difficulty rating. For me, it was a, let's say, a 4 out of a maximum of 5. But still, it's very challenging, and I can imagine that some people, or a lot of people, were really struggling with this one because it's really hard to imagine how to handle it and go step by step through it. Okay, but this was how you have to solve it, or you can solve it. And again, I put you the link in the description where you can buy it. Check this puzzle. Check out puzzlemaster.canada and go through the shop. It's a really nice shop. I really appreciate this one. And if you like this episode and interested to see more in the future, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my YouTube channel, to my Facebook channel, and stay tuned. And as always, if you have any questions, complaints, wishes, ideas, let me know in the comments. And until next time, keep on puzzling.